Welcome to the Newberry Center for Renaissance Studies Learning from Premodern Plagues video series. I'm Stephanie Reitzig, a student at the University of Chicago and intern at the Newberry Library. Today we'll be looking at a 1784 edition of the letters of the Right Honorable Lady Mary Wortley Montagu, focusing in particular on this letter written in 1717 from Turkey to better understand smallpox in 18th century England. Lady Mary Wortley Montagu was an English aristocrat and prolific letter writer who was born May 26, 1689. In 1716, her husband was appointed as the English ambassador to Turkey, and so the couple embarked on the long journey to Constantinople. The trip took them almost 10 months, and along the way, Lady Mary wrote numerous letters to her friends and family members back in England. In this letter, written from Adrianople, which is now Edirne in northwest Turkey, Lady Mary described the process of engrafting or inoculation that was practiced in the Ottoman Empire. The procedure was supposedly performed by a set of old women and consisted of opening a vein with a sharp needle, putting some infectious matter from a smallpox patient into the wound, and then binding it along with some nutshell fragments in order to open more veins. Inoculated individuals would become sickened by this exposure and experience a mild form of the disease, which would last for around 8 days. After this point, they would be, quote, as well as before their illness. Now, Lady Mary's fascination with smallpox inoculation was well warranted, as smallpox was both widespread and deadly in early modern England. One 18th century physician estimated from mortality records that 16 to 20% of individuals who caught smallpox died from it, and that smallpox killed around 1 in 14 children, or around 7% of all children. By the early modern era, smallpox was already known to be a disease which rarely recurred. If you caught it and recovered, you were very unlikely to catch it again. And if so, it would probably be very mild. Inoculation achieved precisely this effect. The procedure artificially exposed people to smallpox, which they typically contracted in a mild form. After recovering from the illness, they would be immune to the disease. This explains Lady Mary's observation that the smallpox, so fatal and so general amongst us, is here entirely harmless by the invention of engrafting, which is the term they give it. Indeed, she was so impressed by the procedure that she decided to have it performed on her young son, Edward, remarking to her correspondent, "There is no example of anyone that has died in it, and you may believe I am well satisfied of the safety of this experiment, since I intend to try it on my dear little son." She held off on the procedure for about a year, but eventually had Edward successfully inoculated in March of 1718. Lady Mary also took it upon herself to advocate for the widespread adoption of the practice in England. She returned to Britain in 1718, and during a severe epidemic of smallpox in 1721, had her young daughter inoculated as well, the first time the procedure had been performed in England. This operation, along with the Princess of Wales' decision to inoculate her own daughters in 1722, sparked a virulent debate in England about inoculation. Some people disputed it based on the medical logic of the day, that it was a bad idea to introduce sick material into the blood, and that this artificially caused distemper might not actually prevent illness from naturally acquired smallpox. Others disdained the medical operation for the fact that its Turkish practitioners and English advocates were primarily women, and for the fact that it came from the Middle East. Still others cited the examples, albeit extremely rare, of inoculated individuals who had later died, despite the fact that this was almost always attributable to other causes. Inoculation fluctuated in popularity in England throughout the 18th century, but its introduction had significant ramifications for the future of medicine. Smallpox inoculation eventually led to vaccination, which was invented by Edward Jenner in 1896 after he observed that individuals who had contracted cowpox did not become infected when inoculated with smallpox, which is alluded to by the cow in this portrait. We can thank these medical advances for the global eradication of smallpox in 1980, as well as for modern vaccination, which helped prevent thousands of deaths each year. In 2014, the Center for Disease Control and Prevention estimated that vaccinations would prevent over 21 million hospitalizations and over 700,000 deaths amongst children in the US born from 1994 to 2013. If you'd like to learn some more about Lady Mary Wortley Montagu, here are some sources you might consider checking out. Thank you for tuning in to Learning from Premodern Plagues. A new installment will be available shortly, but in the meantime, please stay in touch with any questions by emailing renaissance@newberry.org. Stay well, and don't forget your vaccinations.